Okay. Let's start with the product owner. So, a couple of weeks back, I had to go on an unplanned travel to my hometown. There's some serious issue I had to attend, so I had to go to unplanned travel. I did not get any tickets like flight tickets and train tickets. So what I had to do was, I had to travel by bus. So I went to a nearby bus station. So I waited for a couple of minutes. I found a bus, Volvo bus, fantastic. It's a new engine, new bus, fully loaded with oil, petrol, fuel and all. So I got into the bus. Couple of hours travel, what I found was, the driver does not know the route. And he was stopping the bus where he was not supposed to stop. And he was not stopping the bus where there are people who wanted to get into the bus. So finally, after 3-4 hours delay, my travel ended. What I found was it was not a pleasant travel. So I was going from that place where I got down the bus to my home. I thought of, okay, can I relate this travel to Scrum rules? I just wanted to just thinking. So if I have to compare the driver role in Scrum, who's that role? Product owner. So the product owner has four fundamental responsibilities. What do you think of this? The product owner should own this. What is this? Vision. Compared to the driver, he should know where the destination is. Right? The product owner should know the vision of the product. Right? Next, he manages this. What is this? He manages product backlog. That means he is the person who manages the product backlog. And as a product owner, he is responsible for this. Return on investment. Right? How much I am investing versus how much I am getting back. By using some metrics like business value, earned business value. There's some metric he will use it. And as a product owner, I expect the product owner should decide these things. No. Yes, compare this to the driver journey. When he's supposed to stop the bus, where he's supposed to stop the bus, where he's not supposed to stop the bus. So when I want the release. So the product owner's another responsibility is to decide the release dates. But again, collaboration will happen between stakeholders and the development team. As we discussed yesterday, we also should take care of these four W's. Can somebody guess?
What?
That means what is the requirement? What is the right product? Next, why?
Why
we are doing that? Because I have a vision. So, value proposition. Next, when should it go to production or live? Who needs this product? Right? He should take care of this. But how is not part of the product owner. Now, one important word that I always tell the product owners to know, to say, to practice in front of the mirror. No! It's not required because it does not have any value. Right? The most and fundamental important thing is, if the product owner is doing this, he is a dysfunctional product owner. He should not be doing this, right? So, if he has to achieve all these things, he should be fundamentally working with he works with dev team and he works with stakeholders. So what does he work with the dev team and the stakeholders? From the learnings you have from yesterday till now, discuss 2 minutes and identify what he works with dev team. Give me 1 minute. he works with stakeholders. Just spend 2 minutes, try to fill this 2 weeks. What kind of work he does with stakeholders, what kind of work he does with the development team to achieve the responsibilities that we discussed, owning the product vision, responsible for ROI, it's a table activity. You have to